Hi, I'm Kyle with AIS, and today I'm going to show you how to install a print driver on your Mac. Let's go! Okay, so the first thing you want to do is you want to get on a browser, and you're going to type in the search bar Kyocera US downloads. On the first result is going to be product support. Let's go ahead and click on there. And here you're going to be entering the model number of your machine. So in this case, we have a 3051 CI, and it'll pick it for you. Just go ahead and highlight it. And dropping down, it has detected the operating system. It's an Apple. So we're gonna go to the first driver here, and we're gonna click OK, accept and continue. Okay, so this goes into your downloads folder, and we'll go ahead and click on the zip file here. Double click, and so we have our new folder here. So let's click on that, and now we have our Kyocera web build DMG file. We're going to click on that, and with the open box here, we're going to select this, double click, and now we have the installer. So we're going to go ahead and continue, agree, and install. And you're going to have to type in your password. And it's installing. And the installation was successful. So go ahead and click close. And you can either keep this file or not. So now we need the IP address. And how we do that would be with the status page under system menu. Go to your report. Go to print report and status page. Let me go back in here to the Apple system preferences. And under system preferences, we're going to go to printers and scanners. Click on that. Okay, so click on to the plus icon. And you're going to be picking the globe icon. And from here, you're going to type in the IP address from the status page. You're going to keep this line printer daemon, the LPD. And down here at the bottom, it has selected the 3051 KPDL driver, and that's what we want. So with your machine, it's going to be your model number. And we're going to click Add. And OK. And now it's installed. So after installing the print driver, you're going to go to your Finder. You're going to go under Applications. And we'll be finding the Kyocera print panel. And these are all your different functions, pretty much just like the Windows driver. Here is where you'll be able to select between black and white as default or color. And when you first install it, it's going to be a color default. So you want to make sure you change it to black and white, which you could change when you do a print job. And there you go. And if you have any more questions, please give us a call. We'll gladly help you out. And remember, worry less with AIS.